isn't all that great. My automobile is a piece of crap. My fashion sense is a little whack, and my friends are just as creepy as me. I didn't go to boarding schools. Preppy girls never looked at me. Why should they? I ain't nobody, got nothing in my pocket.
Unfiltered Podcast, episode 190, audio version today. Just a flick, like, getting up for a video today. And I'll be honest with you, last couple of days I kind of missed doing it this way with the music intros and the, you know, one of the things I like about doing the audio, it gives you more to do in terms of, when I add files, when I add, like, you know, clips, I want to add music or, you know, any little thing. That's the good thing about doing the audio version of this podcast. And I like doing the audio version of this podcast. The video, and like I said, I'm not gonna do the Periscope, because I'll probably a couple episodes here going forward. But I think I'll probably do more of these audio shows going forward. Kind of miss it a little bit. By the way, I'm coming out with a cold. So if I sound a little nasally, I apologize. If I start coughing or doing all this shit, that disgusting, you know, crap, scratching my nose, whatever. From the inside, I apologize, you know, in advance. By the way, I'm here in my office recording this on my phone. My cat is right next to me, meowing. It's funny, she doesn't meow the entire day, and then the minute I walk into this thing to do the podcast, she starts meowing. Like, come on, you couldn't wait like 10, 15 minutes before I could start doing this? Like, really? Like, you really decided to do this right now? Like, see, there you go again, right now. It's annoying. I don't get it. So today's going to be mostly an NFL-centric show. I think what I'll do is probably throughout the week, I'll probably add more other stuff I want to talk about. I have a couple of things I want to talk about, but I want to kind of get out this show today. And I mean, there's no more Thursday Night Football. Holidays are approaching. I've been working like crazy in my day job, which is good. Money's, you know, making money's always good. But I'm feeling it now. Like, I'm actually taking a few days off from work before I go back and do the same grind again next weekend. But, you know, like I said, the holidays are good. And I'm thinking about also taking a break for the winter. Not from this show necessarily, but I was talking about doing the New York Speaking Podcast, taking 2 weeks off. You know, as you guys know, I got a 5-year-old son. You know, he'll be on break also too, and it's a lot harder to record podcasts when he's home, because a lot of times I do not only this show, but even the Never Speak Podcast, I do when he's at school and when my 1-year-old naps, like right now, for example. But he'll be home for 2 weeks, and it's a lot harder to schedule shows around that time. Now, what stinks is that we're now in the middle of a big time playoff race in the NFL 2 weeks ago. So this may. This will lap into 2019 most likely. So I don't know, I haven't decided yet. Obviously if anything changes on that end, I'll announce it. This show, of course, I can still do whatever. I can do this on the road. I can just, you know, anytime I have away from the house, I can just press record and just kind of spew my thoughts out. By the way, this is episode 190. We're almost at 200. We started the show last summer. We started the show last spring, 2017 springtime. Remember, it was called Earth Speaking Daily for a little while, and then I had to change it to Unfiltered about, I think, about 50 shows in. We kept the numbers going because I figured, you know, just keep the numbers going, keep the vibe going, you know, no big deal. Anyway, I'm ranting too much. Last night's game, Panthers Saints, I guess a bore. I had Saints plus 6.5. The Panthers plus 6.5. So I was right there. I did a 2-team parlay last night. I need something to sweat. So I did a little 2-team parlay. Had the Saints. I had the over in the game, which did not hit. But I had the Panthers plus 6.5, which I was correct on. So I went 2-3 this week on my best bets. I had, you know, last week 4-1. This week 2-3. So the last couple weeks have been inconsistent. And New Orleans is now in position. They won 12-9 last night, and they're now in position, you know, despite the tough win yesterday, they're in position to get the number one seed now. If they win next week, I believe they're number one seed, because they already, even if they end up tied with the Rams, who lost again this week to Philadelphia, you know, Philadelphia team without Carson Wentz, Philadelphia team without the secondary being in shambles, the Rams are in trouble. The Rams are in a little bit of trouble. And people have been saying this, and even me to some degree has been saying this, you know, last couple of weeks, that there's some, you know, blemishes on this Rams team. And you put them in the cold, certainly there's an issue. You saw the Chicago game a couple weeks ago, well, last week rather, where, you know, when they played in the cold against the Bears, they did not respond well. Jared Goff didn't seem to adjust well. But now they're losing games at home against a team like Philadelphia, who was pretty much packing it in, I guess. You would think they're packing it in with Carson Wentz being out probably for the year. I mean, I'm an Eagles fan at any cost, but you got to give that team credit for showing up, number one. So the Rams are in trouble. I think right now, the NFL right now is so wide open, because you can really make a case for at least up to 8 teams to go to the Super Bowl. And yet, if I said, gun in my head, which team do you think has the edge to win the title this year? I would say right now New Orleans has been the most consistent team up to this point. The Chiefs, some concern there too, but they've also lost 3 games by a total of 7 points. So they're pretty much like a play or two from being 14-0, you know. So it's one of those things where, you know, you can't take too much of that, the records either. But, you know, New Orleans is in a position to win the NFC number one seed. And I tell you what, that's going to be huge, because, as you know, the Superdome, New Orleans, one of the toughest places in the league to play. In fact, I would say top 3. You know, so, and Drew Brees is having a phenomenal year. I think Drew Brees, I'm not sure if I would say he took the lead last night, because he didn't really play a great game necessarily. I don't know, it was really a defensive struggle. I would say the MVP race now is down to 3. I would say 4 players now I consider MVP. I would say Drew Brees, obviously Patrick Mahomes, Kansas City, and Andrew Luck, and Indy, I would put in the conversation too. And Philip Rivers is now in the conversation now, with the Chargers playing so well. So it's going to be fascinating to see how things play out as we get toward the end of these last 2 weeks. So, if I don't, like I was saying on top of the show, like, I'm not necessarily, I'm deciding about the Earth Speaker podcast, whether I'm going to take a break for 2 weeks. But in any case, just because I don't have guests on the show, doesn't mean I can't talk to you on this one. This show never stops. So, we'll probably, all my analysis and all my thoughts will come on the show anyway. So, alright, so, of course, today's Tuesday, so we do every week Tuesday. I already post on social media, if you follow me on Facebook or on Twitter, at EJChristian7. I posted my power rankings today, my power 10, my bottom 5, which I do this year. Here's the order, 1 through 10. Well, let's do the worst teams first. Let's do the shitty teams in the league, 20 to 32. 28, the Niners, despite the winning, even though beating the Seahawks. And by the way, for the record, I don't think there's really any horrible teams this year, if you think about it, because there's no 1-15, 2-14 teams this year. The worst team in the league has at least three wins or more, you know? So there's no, this is how you know parity's working in the NFL. There's a lot more competition, even the bottom. Like, somebody has to be bad to some degree, but there's no 1-15 bad, no 2-14 bad. There's at least 3-11, I guess, or better. So that's actually a good thing, really. So 28, the Niners. 29, the Jets. 30, the Raiders went up a little bit. I apologize. They were 30 last week, too. Sorry. 30, the Raiders. 31, the Jaguars, who has been a fucking wreck. Atrocious. They're going to blow things up. I'm hearing rumors about Calais Campbell being cut. I'm hearing things about some star players being cut. Obviously, Blake Bortles. Rumors about him getting cut. Jaguars, you know, this is a team that was literally minutes from going to the Super Bowl last year, and now they're, in my opinion, the second worst team in football through 15 weeks. That's kind of bad. That's really, really bad. So, 32, the Arizona Cardinals. Blown out by Atlanta this weekend. I mean, they're just bad. They're really bad. Okay, so 1 through 10, here we go. 1 through 10, 1 is the Saints. That's not a surprise. And they're going to be likely number 1 seed in the NFC. Number 2, we got some shakeup here. Number 2 is the Chargers. The Chargers with a big win against Kansas City this past Thursday night. They still do not control their destiny. If Kansas City wins out, they still get the number 1 seed in the AFC. But Kansas City does go to Seattle this weekend, so we'll see how that plays out. The Chargers have to play Ravens too this week, so it's a lot of uncertainty in the AFC still. Three, the Chiefs, again, this is a team that's, you know, lost three games by a total of 7 points. I mean, I think that's lost. People talk about, oh, Chiefs were in trouble, this and that, and yes, their defense is not playing well. I definitely agree there. But, again, they've lost by a combined 7 points. I think that needs to be looked at a little more in context. This team is still really good. Four, I got to do it. The Chicago Bears, they're playing balls to the wall. They're playing great football. Trubisky's playing solid, and I mean he's the guy that will determine how far this Bears team go, because their defense is playing so well this year, best D in the league. It travels well, obviously, but if there's any shot about if there's any chance the Bears make the Super Bowl this year, it all relies on Mitchell Trubisky, the quarterback. And we'll see if he's ready for prime time, of course. Number five, I have the LA Rams, who, again, lost two in a row. A little concern there, of course. Most likely number two seed, although I'd be very careful. Although their schedule is pretty easy at the end of the year. They play the Niners and the Cardinals at the end of the year, so we'll see how that goes. But if they slip one more time and the Bears win out, the Bears will be the two seed. So there's still some concern. But I expect the Rams to close out the year in, you know, against the two of the worst teams in football. Number six, I have the Patriots, who are struggling. There's people on social media are telling me I should put in number nine, number eight, or whatever. Look, they're obviously in trouble, 9-5. But I still believe that the Patriots, when they're back against the wall, they're still, at the very least right now, their ceiling is still the AFC title game. And depending on where they're playing that game, which most likely now they're going to have to play week one, unless Houston slips up next week, who's number seven on my list. But we'll see how that goes. Seven is Houston Texans, like I said. Eking out a win against the Jets on Saturday Night Football. But win's a win. You take what you can. Number eight is the Steelers. The Steelers, big win against the Patriots. Still kind of on the fence. I'm not trusting them. Big Ben, you know, of course, one minute he's playing great, one minute he's playing inconsistent. I mean, it's just one of those things. Number nine, the Colts. The Colts, big win against the Cowboys this weekend. Shut him out. Great job by Luck and company. And number 10, of course, the Baltimore Ravens, who are now 8-6. And right now, the Colts and the Ravens are battling out for that sixth seed right now in the wild card race in the AFC. So there's that. And it's funny because this is the last thing before I go. We're talking about the playoffs, of course, 2 weeks away. You know, I think it's time. I never complain about this, and I think I teased a little bit on the podcast 2 days ago on this show. But I think it's time for player reform. I think it's time to consider maybe just, you know, change things up a little bit, like reseeding. Like it's likely the Steelers will win a division, right? It's likely they'll probably go 8-7-1, maybe. And they'll host a playoff game against probably the Chargers or the Chiefs. Where is that? And how is that fair? in what way? And I'm not suggesting we get ready. People say, oh, well, divisions matter. Yeah, they do. I'm not suggesting divisions don't matter. But at the same time, the divisions, to me, the division titles only serve right now, in my opinion, as a automatic bid to the playoffs. But it shouldn't be an automatic home hosting a home game. I don't think it's fair. And I think, you know, people say, oh, well, it happens once every couple of years. Yeah, but it's still often enough to consider the move. So I would, if the NFL Rules Committee, I'm sure, maybe next CBA, that's something that should come up. Reseeding teams again. I don't think it's fair that the Chargers have to go on the road, wild card weekend. Even though they won 13 games. Let's say they go 13-3. You know, I don't think it's fair to the Chargers or the Chiefs. That's just ridiculous. So, I am all for reform in the NFL. So, that's that. Okay, I think that's enough for today. We'll come back tomorrow. Yeah, I like this audio. I'm doing audio again. I'm kind of missed doing the audio version of the show. So, anyway, I'm on Twitter. EJChristian7. Of course, EarthSpeaker Media, EarthSpeaker.net. We'll get back tomorrow with another show. We'll see what happens there. Till then, later. You know where I wanna go. Straight down the Mississippi River to the Gulf of Mexico.